You hikers and backpackers and bushcrafters and travelers and runners who make YouTube videos for others to watch, why do you do it? Well, sure, it lets you share with others a document of doing something you love. But what about the act of making the video itself? Creativity, making something new, it puts a little extra bounce in your step, doesn't it? Day 27. Hiking in the rain towards my third to last campsite. I like hiking with an umbrella because it keeps the rain off my head and I can use it with the tarp to prevent splashes.
Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, look him in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Well, here's how things look the next morning. Under the tarp next to the log, I set up in the rain yesterday about 3 in the afternoon. It kept raining and raining until 2 this morning. Now it's wet and overcast and cold. It's 45 degrees. I don't know how the weather took such a turn, but it did. Out of camp finally and ascending a soggy mountain. And I'm asking myself this question. Am I making these videos because I happen to be hiking the Benton MacKaye Trail? Or am I hiking the Benton MacKaye Trail in order to make these videos? I'm at Enloe Creek. This is a really remote part of the park. We're far away from any access points, and yet there's a steel bridge here over the creek. This bridge is 15 feet above the creek, and yet is still sometimes overtopped by the water in this creek. The reason this bridge is here is because a backpacker long ago died trying to ford the creek. I'm up pretty high now and I'm being pelted with ice. It snowed at higher elevations last night. I just got rain, but now I'm higher than I was overnight. I'm still optimistically hoping that it will clear up. This is called Campsite 44. It's the second to last place I'll be camping on the trip. Kind of a neat area. Sort of an indentation between two mountain peaks. And there's my tarp over there. We're above 5,000 feet and my thermometer says it's 48 degrees now. It's sure to get much colder tonight, so I wanted to go with some sort of a tent-like setup. It's not very symmetrical on the outside, but it's gonna work great. I have the trekking poles on the inside. And pretty well enclosed, I think. Day 29, sun's out this morning. I think I'm gonna have good weather to finish the trip. Well, I descended 2,000 feet this morning and then climbed 3,000, and now I'm finally at Mount Sterling Ridge Trail, which is going to take me to Mount Sterling. Now, of course, I didn't spend a month hiking this trail only in order to make YouTube videos. In fact, I was thinking about this trail even before I began making backpacking videos on YouTube. But I am grateful for the way that YouTube has allowed me to share my experience on the trail, and in a way that has allowed me to indulge my creative side. Look at this. Snow. And I've been thinking on these last days of my hike about the way that it has kind of joined together these two main overarching arcs in my life, both my love of the outdoors and my fascination with creativity.
Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, just look 'em in the eye. I'm here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Top of Mount Sterling, the highest point on the trail, 5,800 feet. I'm gonna go ahead and climb the fire tower, even though I don't think the views are gonna be great. Well, that doesn't look too bad. Just gonna try not to think about it. I think I'm gonna have to put my phone in my pocket. Not bad. This is at the broken pane of glass. Here's what it's like up here without my lav mic. So you get the wind noise. And I don't know what I'm gonna do about my hat. It's about to fly off my head. Boy, did the wind howl through the spruce trees last night. Earplugs. Up early again, hiking down the Baxter Creek Trail to the end of the Benton MacKaye Trail. I'm thinking about my history of hiking over my life. I did a lot of hiking in high school. Started with Boy Scouts, went to Philmont. Then my friends and I threw off the establishment and started doing it on our own. I backpacked in Wyoming and Colorado and all over Missouri. And I kept camping all the time throughout my life, even when I got busy with work. But I haven't started backpacking again seriously until lately. And it's been great. A fascination with creativity connects both ends of my life too. I was always a creative kid in high school. I wanted to have a writing career, maybe be a songwriter or musician. When I went to college, I majored in English. But eventually I realized I was gonna have to pay the bills and I went to law school and became a lawyer. And it often happens in situations like that. Law took over my life. And that's pretty much been the story of my life for the past 30 years. Although I have had plenty of chances to be creative as a lawyer, writing legal briefs or arguing in court or writing books for lawyers, which I've done. I also kept this weblog going for 10 years, legalunderground.com. It's always been on my hat in plain sight in all these videos, and it's still there. And in that blog, I made light of, satirized the legal profession a little bit, even though I was part of it. I was also one of the world's first podcasters during the first podcasting renaissance back in 2004 or so. I made more than 50 episodes that are still up there on the internet somewhere. But now there's YouTube. I mean, YouTube's been around a long time, but I just discovered it, and I really like the opportunity to make videos. It reminds me of the way the internet was and blogs were back in 2004 and 2005. Just lots of opportunities to try out new things and experiment, and just such a wonderful audience. Supportive people who are willing to watch the videos and comment on them. Here it is, the bridge over Big Creek and the official end of the trail. But first, let's pull out the map. Here's where I started, down in Georgia. Went along the red line, got to the Smoky Mountains, and now I'm here at the end. So, why do we keep on doing it? Doing things that we love to do and then making something new of them for YouTube or wherever else. I don't know about you, but for me, I like to backpack alone for the freedom that it gives me. And I like to be creative for the same reason. I can make my own rules, follow my own path, blaze my own trail. Now, with both activities, there are risks involved. With backpacking alone, there are physical risks. With being creative, there are emotional risks. You're taking something very personal of yourself and putting it out there for others to see and opening yourself up to criticism or rejection. But I think in both cases, the rewards are worth the risks. So that's my message to you as I complete the Benton MacKaye Trail. Keep on doing what you love. Keep creating, and thank you so much for following me on my journey.
Just roll me up and smoke me when I die.
Now, even though I'm done with the trail, I still have to hike 6 miles to get back to my car at the Standing Bear Farm and Hostel. Now, Syntax 77, when he finishes the trail, there is always a car there waiting for him. I really need to work on my planning skills.